It's a time of rebuilding for the Iowa Hawkeyes. Dreams of the glory days of Hayden Fry, who once rebuilt the program himself. Now his successor Kirk Ferentz enters year three. Hope does wear black and gold in 2001. Thanks to a strong finish to last season and some returning veterans, the Hawkeye faithful think the long road back looks shorter every day. Stars like Liddell Betts, who enters his senior year as one of the Big Ten's best backs. And the thrilling Khalil Hill, the all-purpose threat. They're the reason for the excitement and anticipation. Now it begins the 2001 season. You're looking live at Kinnick Stadium in Iowa City. It's the season opener for the Hawkeyes of Iowa and the Golden Flashes of Kent State. Hi, everybody. Mike Gleason here. Great to have you on board as we lift the curtain on yet another college football season. Boy, the month of September is a great time for college football fans. College campuses are overflowing with anticipation, which is the case here in Iowa City. But they also went through a week of turbulent waters when one of their key players, quarterback John Buecher, quit the football team. We'll talk more about that in a few minutes, but the bottom line is the fifth-year senior Kyle McCann, he is the starter, and he won't be looking over his shoulder, at least where John Buecher is concerned. McCann starting the last two games, or actually four games of the regular season, splitting 2-2 last year for the Hawkeyes. Now the big question, the junior college transfer. He moves up on the depth chart. That's Brad Banks out of Hines Community College, and last year passed for 2,000 yards, ran for 500. Now he could be one play away from leading this Iowa Hawkeye football team. That's got to be a relief after a controversial week. The source of the controversy, the departure of sophomore quarterback John Buecher, who showed so much promise as the starting quarterback during the middle of last season. Now, this past July, Buecher was involved in an altercation with starting offensive lineman and roommate Sam Aiello. An altercation that led to an emergency room visit for Buecher. A quarterback battle has been ongoing parallel to the controversy. And then on Tuesday, 2 days after Kirk Ferentz decided that Kyle McCann was the starting quarterback, John Buecher decided to leave the University of Iowa. A once bright career as a Hawkeye appears to be over. The McGregor Furniture starting lineup, starting with the backs and receivers for the Iowa Hawkeyes. You have Betts, Allen, Hill, Oliver, and Clark. Now up front for the Iowa Hawkeyes, Gallery, Steinbach, and Nelson, Lightfoot, and Aiello. McCann did pick up the first down, first and 10. The call goes to Betts. He's got some running room. Cuts it back inside. He's over the midfield stripe down to about the 47-yard line. McCann drops his first pass, and he has his tight end, Dallas Clark. The junior out of Livermore, Iowa. The former linebacker picks up his first catch of the season. Gain of 5 on the play for Iowa.
Clark is a walk-on, and the coaches have been very high on him in camp. They think he can really stretch the ball downfield. So let's look for Clark to get the ball quite a bit. They like him a lot.
That's picked up 6 more. This time it's Allen right up the middle. Jeremy Allen. Touchdown, Hawkeye. And Bob Sanders, there's a guy I know you like.
Oh, man, I love that guy. He reminds me a lot of my old teammate Todd Bell, a miniature version of very physical. He'll take on linemen as well as running backs, and he'll put the hurt on you with his hits, I guarantee you that.
Great job by the crew. You saw McCann look off the defender. He was looking for Khalil Hill. Then he came back at the last second and had Jones, which you mentioned should have been caught. Here's the screen to Betts. Betts cuts it back. A lot of green in front of him. Shoots his way over the midfield stripe, still on his feet, past the 40, down to the 35-yard line, finally drops at about the 34. So now it's 3rd and 13 at the 38-yard line. McCann, good coverage, tucks it up. Now he's going to let her go. Hill gets nailed at the 20-yard line, but holds on to the football. Nate Kading, sophomore of Coralville, the kick is up. And he drills it through. And Betts gets the call, cuts to the outside. He coughs up the football. It's alive. Harrison has it. And Harrison goes down at the 10-yard line. Valentino. This one's up for grabs, and it's picked off by Iowa.
That was Roger Meyer. Roger Meyer's been a big play guy for him. He had 8 tackles for losses last year, and he comes from the blind side. Valentino never sees him. Nice pop by Meyer, gets that ball up in the air. And that's what you need. You know, when a team makes a turnover on you, you got to get it right back. When you get leveled as a quarterback by a linebacker, that is not pretty. There's Campman. He's ready to roll.
Aaron Campman with his first interception. He had one last year to go with three sacks. Another first down for the Hawkeyes. Ball resting at the midfield stripe. Not anymore. Here's Allen, the big fullback. He's got some running room. He's down to the 35-yard line.
I can't tell you how impressed I am with Allen. And this shows you, I mean, he didn't run anything like this last year. Now watch the way he hits that hole. And good surge, a good blocking there by the offensive line of Iowa.
Liddell Betts gets the call. Cuts it back up, down to the 20, dropped at about the 17-yard line.
Oh.
This year, for the first time in 3 years, we have a chance finally now to have some experience and depth out there, and we think we're going to have a representative Big Ten line. We're very pleased with the way these guys have hung tough. They've grown, and they've gotten bumped around a little bit, and I think they're going to be able to go out and play the way they want to play and the way we want them to play, and what the effect that'll have on our entire offense, I think, will be real significant. It's been a little tough to be a running back and quarterback at Iowa the last couple of years.
So now, Kading's on for a 31-yard attempt. Here's the kick. He already has one this afternoon. Make it two. So Nate Kading, with a couple of field goals, has pushed the lead now for the Iowa Hawkeyes to 13. Third down and four at the 26-yard line. McDaniels feeling the heat again. Heavy pressure that time. It's Derek Pickens, the senior out of Houston, Texas. They're looking at Liddell Betts. Outside of Damian Anderson, Betts has to be out to prove that he deserves to be maybe a first team. Quarterback now. And it's complete to the tight end. And inside the 15-yard line, Brad Banks came in while we were talking. He's the junior college transfer out of Hines Community College.
Well, it's interesting. Both teams made a change in their quarterbacks. Kent State didn't have a good result. Iowa has a very good result on that play. Banks has some mobility. And Clark, they've talked about Clark getting downfield. I'm impressed with his running ability. Now watch him shake off two tacklers, and he has some speed for a tight end. Nice cutback, and he almost shakes free for a touchdown.
Well, Brad Banks comes in. His first play as an Iowa Hawkeye goes 38 yards. He passed for 2,000, ran for 500 at Hines Community College. One time redshirt behind Dante Culpepper at Central Florida. Aaron Grebbing now, the backup tailback. Still on his feet, cuts inside, touchdown! Aaron Grebbing, the sophomore out of Ames, Iowa. And right now, Iowa seems to be doing quite well. Murphy coughs up the football. It's loose, and a Hawkeye jumps on it.
That kills you.
Derek Pagel.
And that's the key to most success in football, to have a steady quarterback. Someone's going to be there, and everybody get used to it.
This one's complete to Hill, right over the middle. And he's inside the 40, down to about the 36-yard line. Khalil Hill. What? Lunzel and J.D. Jr. played at Washington, Shelby at Syracuse, and now Hakeem, a freshman at Arizona State. Those are strong, strong bloodlines.
I'm upset at J.D., though. He didn't get all his kids to Arizona State.
There's the tight end. Dallas Clark still on his feet inside the 15-yard line.
Wow.
Down to 3 seconds to go. Kading with the kick.
Automatic.
And Nate Kading's 3 for 3.
Automatic.
And that's going to be the final play of the first half of play here from Kinnick Stadium. The Iowa Hawkeyes trying to turn the corner now, maybe see a bowl. We'll be back with Al's comments coming up momentarily. It's halftime. We're going to take a timeout. There's the numbers. It's 23-0, Iowa. You're watching Big Ten football from ESPN+. Had a chance to talk with Kirk Ferentz about his number one back.
He's a tremendous competitor, I think an excellent running back. And again, it's been a little bumpy. We've been inexperienced and young up front. We've had injuries, what have you. And I've never seen Liddell demonstrate any negative body language. He's never been negative in any way. Very supportive of his teammates, very understanding. And I think it'd be wonderful to see his, just the way he's carried himself, see that rewarded with a great season for him.
Aaron Grebbing checks into the lineup. He gets the call. Does he get the touchdown? Indication says he's got it. He's 2 for 2 as far as touchdowns. 2 carries, 2 touchdowns.
Not too many guys can say that.
30-0 now. The Iowa Hawkeyes on top of the Golden Flashes. You're watching Big Ten Football from ESPN+. Looked like he was holding his wrist down on the sidelines, but he is back on the field. That's him in motion right now behind McCann. And they keep it on the ground. And Robbie Crockett shows a thing or two as he breaks off a big gainer for the Hawkeyes. The 6'1", 207 senior out of Battle Creek, Michigan, 15 yards on the play. McCann coming into the season with 2,300 yards. 4th and 1, they go for it. Greving, is he going to be 3 for 3? Aaron Greving, touchdown!
Oh, my goodness.
Unbelievable.
Oh, my goodness.
The former state champion in the 100 meters goes 26 yards. He's gone 14, 1, and 26. He's carried 3 times, all touchdowns.
That, my friends, is incredible.
Maybe that's why he's number 2 on the depth chart.
I don't know, you know, I don't know what the stats say in the NCAA, but I don't know if anyone's ever scored 3 touchdowns in their first 3 runs. Maybe first 2 runs, but first 3?
Right. And 2 of them, big gainers, 14 and 26.
Yeah, so you're not talking about something 1 or 2 yard deal.
Nate Kading's perfect this afternoon on kicking. It's 37-0, Hawkeyes on top of Kent State.
Who is this Iowa team? Is this the same Iowa team we saw last year?
Well, you know what? Towards the end of the season.
Watch this hole. Steinbach pulling there. Nice block by Crockett, number 15. A converted halfback. They put him at fullback. He makes a great block there. Reaping does all the rest. Watch Crockett. If you can see him, 15. He knocks somebody on the backside right there. Nice hole. A good acceleration. You can see why he's a 100-meter champ there. And he used good step arm there. Greving. Very impressive. Talking about being rich in the backfield.
So you talk about the Iowa rushing attack. Of course, Betts now is 9 100-yard games. He's at 99. Does he come back in? Allen at 73. And Aaron Greving's going to grab some of those headlines. 3 for 3, 41 yards and 3 touchdowns.
Well, the way Allen and Greving are running, you might have 3 backs with over 100 yards before this game is over.
Mr. Banks back on the field. Young man getting a nice ovation from this Iowa crowd. A junior out of Belglades, Florida. He was in for 2 plays in the first half. They went 52 yards for a touchdown, a 38-yard completion on his first play. So Fred Russell. We've seen enough ball carriers. Now Fred Russell gets the call, and he's up close to the first down. Ochoa in motion now. Banks gives it to Russell. He's got some moves. He's quick. Cuts it back over the 20-yard line. Dropped it about the 22. No, I take it back. He wasn't dropped. He was stood up. You know, Liddell Betts sitting on the sidelines. A big game. 9 100-yard games. He has 99 yards. I'll bet you Kirk Ferentz has no idea he's at 99.
I have a feeling someone will relay that message down to the sidelines since we've mentioned that.
Crockett, some running room. Robbie Crockett over the 35, up to the 37-yard line. Boy, a stable of backs or an awesome offensive line.
Yeah, when you have that all together, it works.
So Crockett picks up 16 more.
Look at that hole. That's kind of easy to run through. I think I might even be able to make 5 yards in that hole.
Banks, play action, comes back the other way. It's Freddie Russell, the 45, midfield. Russell on his feet, 45-40. Fred Russell down to the 35-yard line. Brad Banks, another Floridian. Russell breaks to the outside. Russell kicks it in the fifth gear, down to the 15-yard line.
But you know what? It's an advantage for running backs to be short like that.
Massacoy got it this time. Oh, no indication yet. Looked like he broke the plane.
Watch Massacoy right here. He has somebody wrapped right there. Look at him. Drag him right into the end zone.
You know who hit him first? A 270-pound linebacker, but Pierre Wilson, the Michigan State transfer, couldn't hold on.
Man, oh, man, that's impressive.
Now, here's Kading after back-to-back state titles. Led the team in scoring last year. As a matter of fact, his high school coach, Reese Morgan, now an assistant at Iowa. Kading keeps the streak alive. He's perfect on the afternoon. So, Siaka Massacoy finally gets in for the touchdown. It's 44-0, Iowa on top. Then in April, he said, in a perfect world, the Hawkeyes would start fall drills with a legitimate number one quarterback. Well, they didn't start fall drills, but now they have McCann and Banks look good for a first time out for the junior college transfer here this afternoon.
And they lost another legitimate number one quarterback who just quit.
Exactly. So Fritz, this one off the side of his foot. Jones got some running room.
What he's famous
he
for.
He could take it to the house. Oh, he goes down at the 15-yard line. C.J. Jones, as Al alluded to earlier, 8 punt returns for touchdowns. On the J.C. level, he almost had one there.
You know, C.J. has a lot of confidence. Benny Sapp says he's a big-time trash talker in practice. He has a lot of ability, and he's very happy there.
Iowa Hawkeyes, after averaging 17 points a game in the 2000 season, and now with 44 on the board, and they're knocking on the door again.
Yeah, and you know, the thing you have to be impressed with Iowa here, you know, they start off this week with a big controversy, future suddenly quitting, but they come out here, you know, they didn't let that distract them. They've been very aggressive.
And looks
like they're going to score another touchdown.
Fred Russell bounced off the would-be tackler, and he was off to the races. This guy can scat. 13 yards, another Iowa touchdown. Russell's first of the afternoon.
I tell you, I didn't get a chance to explain how good they're doing, and they score a touchdown so fast. I mean, they're just throwing running back after running back at Kent State, and there's nothing Kent State can do about it.
You know, Kirk Ferentz's first win, 24-0 against Northern Illinois. That was the last time the Hawkeyes recorded a shutout. That's going to be the last play of this football game. So, Al, your final comments on this 51-0 victory for the Hawkeyes.
Very impressive win for Iowa. They're going to have a lot of momentum next week. Kent State has to go back to the drawing board.
Well, once again, the final score from Kinnick Stadium, Iowa 51, Kent State nothing. Don't forget ESPN Plus has Hawkeye action again next week as the black and gold go for win number 2. Kirk Ferentz and company host Miami of Ohio. That's at 11 a.m. Central. Check your local listings. Now for Al Harris and the entire ESPN Plus crew, this is Mike Gleason. Thanks for joining us today. This has been a presentation of ESPN Plus, the worldwide leader in collegiate sports television. So long, everybody, from Iowa City.